pot dupe drums, a noisy basketball, and a 5-year-old's birthday party have in common? Well, get this, they have all been the subject of noise complaints.
That's right. Noise complaints are on the up and up around the country, and one community really feels they're not being heard. Here's Jill.
Never mind the weather, how's the noise been where you are? Well, here's some of the more unusual complaints. In the north, it was rescue choppers. So many complaints to council, they're thinking of moving the base. And in Taupo, possums. Not only running, but breaking sticks. To Gisborne now, and neighbours were riled by backyard basketball before school, and down to Porirua, where the city council's been asked to get the police to turn down their sirens. I mean, they are noisy. And a southerly change in Waimakariri district. Complaints about a booming stereo. Okay, but from a passing truck and Dunedin. Student parties, of course, but also a deafening duck. But head to the Chatterns. And what they lack in sunshine, they make up for with peace and quiet. Ka pai, Chathams, not a single complaint to council. It's a situation most of us can only dream of. Urban life can be loud. Take backyard basketball. The noise might be annoying, excessive even, but complaining to council? One hoop shooter's dad was in disbelief.
Noise complaints involved with a basketball being bounced in the driveway is just ludicrous.
Most councils don't consider it unreasonable if it's during waking hours.
These people live in a small community of suburbia where there are children up and down the street everywhere, and children make noise. I love that noise.
But while any noise can annoy a person, what about ones that affect a whole neighbourhood? Every day, for months.
The impact on me is that this constant, incessant, inescapable noise keeps me awake at night.
The effect on health shouldn't be underestimated.
Our cardiovascular health is impacted by exposure to long-term noise, where our heart can't beat in a relaxed way. There are these other impacts as well on our immune system, on our mental health.
Want to hear what that's like on a daily basis?
Lack of sleep, I mean, it's just, it makes you, can be pretty emotional sometimes.
It's really disorientating and, it just made me feel nauseous and really unwell.
And it's like water torture, it's terrible.
These residents in Upper Hutt are running on empty.
I've tried sleeping with earplugs, I've tried active noise reduction headphones, I've tried noise generators, I tried an app that makes the sound of rain on the roof. I can't escape from it.
They say the problem started when the Farrah's wraps factory ramped up its night operations, leading to a sound like a low invasive hum like this for over 18 long, annoying months.
It's like the bass of a boy racer's car that's parked outside your bedroom window all night.
It sounds like a Cessna is hovering over our house, or like a big transformer, electrical transformers right outside our bedroom.
Life before Farrah's was good, peaceful even. Back then, the site was used by foodstuffs. The number of people complaining was zero. But now it's dozens that are bending the ear of Upper Hutt City Council, among them Jane and Logan.
We're walking zombies and we can barely function. I don't know how we've managed to hold down jobs.
I often have to take medication so I can sleep, which is something I don't want to do as a parent.
They see their daughter suffer too. Take the night before we spoke.
We decided to move her at about 10 p.m. We moved her to another room. She still struggled to sleep.
Jane, who's trained as a lawyer, says they've tried everything.
Contacted local MPs, government, the ombudsman. So we've met with the council, but we've been unsuccessful.
And they say Farrah's has refused to engage, which our noise expert says makes things worse.
If you feel suspicious or annoyed with the people who are making the noise, you're much more likely to feel upset. Some kind of communication and dialogue between the groups can really, really help.
The council has measured the noise, including here in Jane's house. It's too loud, breaching acceptable levels. The council then issued an abatement notice, but only for Farrah's to measure the noise levels.
Might give them a 1 out of 10 because they've actually done enough measurements to prove that Farrah's are breaching, and Farrah's admit that they are breaking the law.
And the reasons residents say they've been told more couldn't be done to reduce the noise?
One was that they're an essential food supplier, so therefore they needed to let them carry on. Another one was that a mystery part was going to arrive in 2 or 3 weeks. Oh, people will lose their jobs.
Upper Hutt City Council told FEGO it's not taken a more heavy-handed approach because...
We believe doing so would have likely extended this process further and been of greater cost to all parties.
Adding it took an evidence-based approach to avoid a potential legal battle, and that...
The Ombudsman agreed the council did not act unreasonably.
Just to be clear, residents don't want to get rid of Farrahs. People love their apps. It's just the noise.
Absolutely, yeah. We want them to be a successful business, and we've suggested lots of ways that they could do that, including changing their working hours.
And because they've refused to engage with us, we can't even understand where they're coming from. There's commercial off-the-shelf products available to sort this problem out. There have been all the way along.
It gets worse, though. Not only has Farrah's failed to solve the noise of the first silo, it wants a second one.
I don't know what you're supposed to do in this day and age to get someone to act. I thought the council was supposed to represent ratepayers.
But despite the residents' efforts, the council supported expansion at a recent resource consent hearing. It's on the understanding Farrah solves the problem by April next year and partially reduces the noise before Christmas. But it still means noisy nights for another 6 months, because Farrah says night operations are essential to keep the business afloat.
It's appalling that it's dragged on 18 months.
It's like we're fighting the war and it's not really our job to do that.
Yeah, it's not good enough.
Fair Go would say Farrah's response to us wasn't either. The company failed to answer any of our direct questions, but it did say sorry. It pointed out the factory was on industrial zoned land and that it had reduced or eliminated some sources of noise and had applied to continue with only low-level noise exceedance until equipment arrived to fix the problem next year. But the residents argue it's all about profit and the price shouldn't be their health.
We just want to be able to sleep in our own home. We could do it for the 8 years before Farrah's moved in. We're not people who like to complain. We just want to have our life back.
That is tough, isn't it? That is a very tough situation to be living in. Look, in its submissions for resource consent, Farrah says it'll look at setting up a community liaison.
Now, a decision from the hearing is due by the beginning of December, which is like 2 weeks away, and the residents are hoping that will really force some change.
Yes, and we'll put up some tips about how you can deal with the noise issue on our Facebook page.